The Unity game engine can be used for 3D game development as well as 2D games. While 3D games generally involve polygonal models rendered through a perspective camera, 2D games contrast this by using 2D bitmap images and orthogonal or isometric camera views. In this series, we'll use MyAlt to export a sprite sheet for a character, and then insert those sprites into a 3/4 overhead isometric 2D game. Start by setting MyAlt's current project to the provided Source Assets folder. Then open the file stanrun.mlt. This character's run animation lasts 24 frames on our timeline. To generate a sprite sheet, we'll need to take a snapshot of each of these frames. To do this, we'll make use of MyAlt's Playblast command. Playblast doesn't use a dedicated renderer with custom settings to generate image stills. Rather, it captures the viewport precisely as you see it. So to use this to its best effect, we'll need to set up our scene in the viewport first. Switch to the custom isometric game cam camera. This is a perspective camera we set up in advance to frame our character appropriately for our game. To better frame your scene, don't move the camera, but rather stretch the attribute editor so that the scene is roughly a square. Next, we need to get our scene looking its best before we create a playblast. We'd like to leverage MyAlt's support for DirectX 11 shaders. Go to Window, Settings and Preferences, Preferences. In the Display section, under Viewport 2.0, make sure Rendering Engine is set to DirectX 11. If it wasn't originally set to this, you will need to restart MyAlt after making this change. Now let's adjust the actual viewport settings to ensure the highest quality output. In the Anti-Aliasing section, turn on Multi-Sampling Anti-Aliasing and set Sample Count to 8. This will ensure that the boundaries of your character will be smoothed out and not jagged in the resulting sprite sheet images. Also enable Screen Space Ambient Occlusion. This will add more realistic lighting by allowing points on the mesh exposed to ambient light to be lit brighter than those that aren't. Now we're ready to playblast our scene. Go to the window Playblast Options. By default, MyAlt will playblast the entire range of the time slider. However, at 30 frames, the time slider actually overshoots the 24-frame animation, so let's instead playblast only that section. We also want to turn off the Show Ornaments option, so the HUD and grid won't appear in our output images. By default, MyAlt playblasts to a movie file format. However, since we're creating a sprite sheet, we'd prefer to have a sequence of still images instead. Set format to image and encoding to PNG. This is a good format that balances quality and file size, as well as supports transparency. Set display size to custom. The output resolution of 256 by 256 is well suited for this character's use in a mobile game. We'll also set scale to 1, so the output size is exactly the resolution we've set. Finally, we'll turn on Save to File and save this animation as stanAnimationSprites/stanRunForward.png in our Source Assets folder. Now click Playblast. MyAlt generates the images as it plays through the scene, then displays a preview in the FCheck viewer. Because we're using an overhead perspective in our game, we'll need to generate additional sets of images for the character running away and to the side as well. Select the mesh and rotate it 180 degrees in the Y-axis. If you notice your model doesn't actually rotate 180 degrees, then it likely means that MyAlt is set to work in radians mode. If this is the case, go to Window, Settings and Preferences, Preferences. In the Settings section, change the angular attribute to degrees. Playblast the animation again, this time under the name Stan Run Back. Finally, select the mesh again and rotate it 90 degrees in the Y-axis. Playblast the animation a final time under the name Stan Run Side. Now we can take all the angles and arrange them to create a sprite sheet. While you can do this on any image editing software, we're going to use Texture Packer. This specialized software perfectly aligns the sprites with each other, which is very important to achieve smooth animation. Open Texture Packer and choose the Lite version. Now drag your Stan Animation Sprites folder into the Sprites panel. Texture Packer automatically arranges the images on a sprite sheet. We need to make a few changes though. Set Algorithm to Basic and Sort By to Name. Also set Border Padding and Shape Padding to 0 and set Trim Mode to None. This will ensure the images appear in the right order and are precisely the right size. We'll also need to resize the sheet in order to fit all these images. Let's use a fixed size of 2048x4096. Now click the Publish button and put the sprite sheet in the same folder as the individual sprites. Name it Stan Animation Sprites. The sprite sheet is ready to be used in Unity. In the next movie, we'll integrate that sprite sheet into an existing Unity game.